Hello students, let us solve today some problems based on areas of similar triangles. Let us solve the next question. Question is, areas of two similar triangles are 225 square centimeter and 81 square centimeter. If a side of the smaller triangle is 12 centimeter, then find the corresponding side of the bigger triangle. There are areas of two similar triangles which are given. Be 225 and 81 square centimeters. Side of the smaller triangle is given. From that we have to find the side of the bigger triangle. So here, as there are two similar triangles are given, we'll have the variables for that. So let the areas of two similar triangles be A1 and A2, and let the sides be S1 and S2. Now here let us consider A1 as a bigger triangle and A2 as the smaller one. Area of the bigger triangle is given to be 225 square centimeters. So we should have here A1 is equal to 225 square centimeter, and as A2 is the smallest, that's why A2 is equal to 81 square centimeters. Now, as second triangle is smaller, S2 must be corresponding side of a smaller triangle, which is given, that's 12 centimeter. And from this information, we have to find the side of bigger triangle. So again, these two triangles are given to be similar, so we have to use theorem of areas of similar triangles. By that, if you take the ratio of areas of these two triangles, that is A1 by A2, must be equal to ratio of squares of corresponding sides, that is S1 square divided by S2 square. A1 here is 225, A2 is 81, is equal to S1 square. We have to find S1 square divided by S2 is 12. So we'll replace here S2 by 12. That's why we get here 12 square. So if you take 12 square, that is 144, to the left hand side, it will be in the numerator, that is to get 225 divided by 81 into 144 is equal to S1 square. Now if you take square root on both the sides, we get square root of 225, that's 15, divided by square root of 81 is 9, into square root of 144 is 12, that is equal to S1, as the square root of S1 square is S1. Now if we simplify this expression on the left hand side, we get 5 into 4, that is equal to S1. 5 into 4, that's 20, is equal to S1. This S1 is equal to 20 centimeter. That means corresponding side of the bigger triangle is 20 centimeter. Let us have the next question. Triangle ABC and triangle DEF are equilateral triangles. Area of triangle ABC is to area of triangle DEF is equal to 1:2. If AB is equal to 4, we have to find DE. In this question, it is given that triangle ABC and triangle DEF are equilateral triangles. We know that any two equilateral triangles are similar triangles. That's why triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. And now, as these two triangles are similar, we can use the theorem of areas of similar triangles. And by that, we can write area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle DEF is equal to corresponding sides we have to take are AB and DE. So we should write here AB square divided by DE square. Area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle DEF. This ratio is given to be 1:2, that is 1 divided by 2. That is equal to AB is 4, that's why 4 square divided by DE square. To simplify this, we get, if we cross multiply, we get DE square into 1, that's DE square, is equal to 4 square 16 into 2. Is 32. So we get DE square is equal to 32. We take square root on both the sides, we get DE is equal to under root 32. We can further simplify root 32, as we have to split this as under root 16 into 2, where 16 is the perfect square of 4. So if you take 16 outside the square root sign, we should take its square root, that is 4 root 2. So this is the length of segment DE. Now let us solve one activity based on this property. In the figure, it is given that segment PQ is parallel to segment DE. Area of triangle PQF, that is the smaller triangle, is 20 square units. PF is equal to 2 into DP. That means PF is double the segment DP. Then we have to find area of DPQE by completing this activity. So here, the activity starts with area of triangle PQF, which is given to be 20 square units, it should be. and PF is equal to 2 into DP. So let us assume that the length of segment DP as X. So if DP is X, PF must be 2 into X, that's 2X. Now we get DF. As we can see in the diagram, D, P and F are the collinear points. So by that, if we add DP and PF, we get DF. By that you can write DF is equal to DP plus PF. So as we can see in the diagram, DP plus PF, that's DF. We have the values for both of these. DP is, we have assumed DP as X plus PF as 2X. So X plus 2X, that's DX given. Consider triangle FDE for triangle FDE and triangle FPQ. For these two triangles, we have to collect pairs of congruent angles. So angle FDE, so as we can see in the diagram, angle FDE must be congruent to one angle which is the corresponding angle of that. So if you consider this angle FDE, its corresponding angle is FPQ. So we should have here angle FDE congruent to FPQ, as these two are corresponding angles, as it is given that PQ is parallel to DE. So as these two lines are parallel, and if we consider DF as the transversal, these two angles are corresponding angles. And we know that if two lines are parallel, then the corresponding angles are congruent. So by that, we have here angle FPQ. In the same way, we have another pair of corresponding angles, that is angle FED. Its corresponding angle is FQP. So here we have angle FQP, as again, these are the corresponding angles. Now for these two triangles, triangle FDE and triangle FPQ, two pairs of corresponding angles are congruent. That's why these two triangles are similar by AA test. And we know that if two triangles are similar, then ratio of their areas is equal to ratio of squares of their corresponding sides. So by that we can write area of triangle FDE divided by area of triangle FPQ is equal to DF square divided by PF square, which are the corresponding sides of these two triangles. Now here we have values for both DF and PF. So DF is 3x, so we have written here 3x bracket square divided by PF is 2x, that's 2x square. If we simplify this one, we get 9 divided by 4. So we have area of triangle FDE divided by area of triangle FPQ is equal to 9 divided by 4. Now here in the denominator we have area of triangle FPQ. If we transfer area of triangle FPQ to the right hand side, it will be in the numerator, so as to get the expression area of triangle FDE is equal to 9 divided by 4 into area of triangle FPQ, which is equal to 9 divided by 4 into, we have area of triangle FPQ, which is given, area of triangle PQF is nothing but area of triangle FPQ, which is given to be 20 square units. So we should replace here area of triangle FPQ by 20. Now if we divide 20 by 4, we get 4 5s are 20, 9 into 5, that's 45 square units. That must be the area of triangle FDE. Now finally, we have to find the area of quadrilateral DPQE. If we observe the diagram, in this diagram, if we add area of the smaller triangle FPQ and area of quadrilateral DPQE, we get the area of bigger triangle FDE. So if we subtract the area of the smaller triangle from the area of the bigger triangle, we get area of the quadrilateral DPQE. So that is expressed here, area of quadrilateral DPQE is equal to area of triangle FDE, which is the bigger triangle, minus area of triangle FPQ, which is the smaller triangle. So we have the area of triangle FDE, we have just found to be 45 square units, minus area of triangle FPQ, which is given to be 20 square units. 45 minus 20, that's 25 square units. That must be the area of quadrilateral DPQ. So these are the some problems which are based on theorem of areas of similar triangles.